All right, so this is going to be my first ever true wet shave. We're not going to do the head yet. We have to wait till tomorrow. I got a head tattoo. And we'll do the big reveal shave on that tomorrow. It's been about a month. But today, we are going to do cheeks, neck, maybe back of the neck. First, we're going to set up this razor. My very first time ever setting up one of these. Now, I will let you know that for a couple months I've been using a shave-it, which I've actually really enjoyed, and I got this more for this, which we'll get into. So we're going to set this puppy right here. Now we've had this brush soaking while I took a shower in some nice warm water, because I've heard that's what you're supposed to do. Now we're going to wring it out. Set it on its little standy stand there. Bring her up here. Alright. Here's the Dova that I've been using. I loaded it today with both blades are loaded today with Visgods. Enjoy your shave. Alright. Now I've also had my soap here blooming while I was in the shower because I was told that that was a good thing to do. So I tried it and it seemed to work out so far. So we're going to tilt this just a little so you can see what we're doing here. Let's actually see what happens if we actually turn the ring light on. Wow, beautiful. That's too much. There we go. Cool. I wonder if I can let's see what happens if we do, like, bear with me, guys. We're just, doing some experimentation here. Trying to get the, best angle for this video that we could possibly get. And I think once I start shaving, that should be a pretty good angle right there. I put a little bit of shave oil on as soon as I got out of the shower. Got my candle lit. We're ready to rock and roll, I believe. I just wanted to let you see this. We're going to use Future Fiction today. Alright, so I'm just going to kind of load this bad boy up like it owes us some money. Got our new barber towels. We're gonna wet one of these bad boys. Everything nice and wet. A little on the glasses, that ain't gonna hurt nobody. I'll say right away, you can feel a little tingle from the citrus oils and stuff, but I like that, so. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to blow in and do a first pass with my handy dandy Dovo, my Dovo Arigato, if you will. And we're gonna do a first pass with that, and we're gonna see where we go from there. Tell you right away, this lather is very nice. Not gonna go too crazy there. Come over to the other jar. If anybody has any tips or advice to what I'm doing that could help me, greatly appreciated. Like I said, this is my first time truly doing this. And I've been using the Dovo long blades. I can honestly say that I think I like that style a little better. Got a little nick here. That's all right. And I'll take anybody's advice, whether it's on grip, whether I'm doing it right, whether I'm doing it wrong. notice this blade to be a definite bit more,
I said like nippy.
And what I'm used to got me a few more times than what I'm used to. But first pass, not too bad. We're gonna put the old shave head down and we're gonna go in. We're gonna reapply. That's what we do with the wipe down. I would like to say that this CK6 formula really sudsy, makes a very good lather. Alright, and while we're here, I'm actually going to go ahead and use a little bit of this here gel. Just to make sure my beard line is where I want it to be. Picked up my razor. Balance. This one's a little lower. Okay. We're done with this razor for now. We're going to go ahead and rinse that bad blood out. Take this puppy out. There's a wrench sticker to the old magnet. I'll show you that in a minute. Alright, now, go to the face again. All right. Now we're going to go in for pass number two, cross grain, using this other razor that we've never used before. We're going to see how that goes. A little soap soupier the second time. Probably could have gone in that's better. Well, let's see how it goes. First time ever using a DE razor. Shout out to PAA. Shout out to Doug for helping me out. This is a green ray, by the way. PAA. Alright. For the face, I'm just gonna do so far. First few swipes, I definitely enjoy it. Here we go. Cross grain. Might have got ourselves there. That might just be one of those areas where you gotta go. Oh no, it's just high. Alright, cool. The sink down a little and talk about how shaved my sinks get quite excessively hot. So line. is going to be my last pass, so I'm going to go ahead and rinse this bad boy out. Alright. I think it's going to be an upward pass. I've just been kind of putting it down and kind of trying to feel. Where it bites. I do want to say this. This is a beautiful razor. Especially for the price. And the kit that it came in was lovely. My wife is currently using it to hold some stuff for herself, because I'll show you my shave kit and how I have my stuff set up here in a second. But I have to say, alright guys, first shave's done. I believe I should rinse this. Rinse my hands. Rinse the sides. Rinse the soap. Let that dry out. Get this one quiet, let it dry out a little bit. I gotta say, overall, I'm a believer. I can see why people do this, and I think I like it better. Than the straight edge razor. Don't tell my straight edge group people that I said that. Definitely got a few nicks and cuts here, but that was from using the single edge blade, not the DE. And I gotta say, the shave is closer than anything I had gotten with my shavette. Alright. Now we're going to use our kitty towel to dry the face off. Do a little inspection here. Just did the beard design a little weird on this side compared to this side, which looks pretty good actually. I'm just gonna take this and do a little detail work. Alright, so, take this off. Whew. Actually, I'm going to set it down for just a second, because it is piping hot. And I'm going to readjust. And I'm going to let you see what I got going on down here. Alright, so I'm one of those people who like has to have everything super clean every single time, so I'm going to take this thing all apart, take that off there, take this off, rinse the blade, pop it on my magnet. I'll show you the magnet in a second. Saw that from the Art of Shaving guy. And I thought it was a good idea, so I stole it for myself. All right, let it breathe. Should be home alone. It. I think it's really hot today. Alright, so, brush. And my scuttle should be here soon. When that comes, I won't need that cup anymore. So I've been told you want to rinse this brush out real good. Squeeze it out with this. Place it on its stand to air dry. So that's important. Alright, so rinse this bad boy off. Rinse this bad boy off. Very little irritation. But I feel like all the irritation that I have came from using a single edge blade. But the scab was not my favorite thing that I've ever put in my Velvo. I'm going to be completely honest with you. I don't know if it was too aggressive, I don't know, it was just a little bitey for me. Place the razor here, which actually sits on there quite nicely. Then I like to take this one, grab me one of these here, your Q-tips, and just take the smaller side and twist it in there and dry it out. Clean that off. Dry off the plastic. Close her up, set her back inside the box, close up our old aftershave here, set her back inside the box. We're going to leave the soap out because we got to let it dry off. And then I'm just going to show you guys one more thing I kept talking about. My magnet. This is what I was talking about here. Boom, hold your blades, keeps them out of the way, good to go. Now, I will say I really like those blades inside of that DE razor, but I did not like those blades inside of my Dovo. So, we'll keep trying different combinations, and we'll go from there. But, I gotta say, man, pretty smooth. Pretty smooth. I enjoyed that shave. Thanks, guys. Have a good day.